Brigantia Blackbird of the Blackbird Grimoire. Welcome to the daily forecast for Tuesday, November 12th, 2024. It is the 22nd of Scorpio, the day of trade. And before we go any further, look over my shoulder here. I want to show you something. There is Isadora and Calliope being all cuddly on the back of the sofa. They're so sweet. Anyway, I thought a little bit of cat cuddling would help a brighten your day on Tuesday. I mean, it's Tuesday. We need all the happy thoughts we can get. Our astrology for the day, the sun is in Scorpio, fixed water, representing resourcefulness. The moon is second quarter Aries, cardinal fire, representing beginnings. Mercury is in Sagittarius, mutable fire, which is to be opinionated. Venus is in Capricorn, cardinal earth, which is to be reserved. Mars is in Leo, fixed fire, representing focus. Jupiter is retrograding in Gemini, mutable air, which is to broaden perspective. Saturn is retrograding in Pisces, mutable water, which is to redefine dreams. Uranus is retrograding in Taurus, fixed earth, representing rebellion. Neptune is retrograding in Pisces, mutable water, which is spiritual awakening. And Pluto is in Capricorn, cardinal earth, representing reconstruction. For our retrograde reminders, for Jupiter, reconnect with your true path. For Saturn, reclaim your authority. For Uranus, reconsider how you rebel. For Neptune, reclaim your magic. And for Chiron, restore the heroic spirit. Yeah. Okay, now the slide's going. Our moon is in the stage of waxing gibbous, which means it's time to cultivate intentions. We have an Aries moon now, so our do's are courage, brainstorming, and decisions. And our don'ts are conflict resolution, routine duties, sharp objects. Be careful of those. But nevertheless, pursue your priorities and move ahead at full steam today. The Aries moon is very close to the full moon, so the energy is rising, and that works very beautifully with Mars and Leo's. And because Mars and Leo is rejecting distractions, so remember your goals, set aside the time. It's okay to shut out the rest of the world today if that's what it's going to take in order for you to get things done. So cultivate that single-mindedness. You have all kinds of energy to be hyper-productive, so I do hope you make the most of that today. Our tarot is the Eight of Cups. Eights represent new beginnings. The Suit of Cups is the emotional feminine, receptive energy, the water element, and emotion. And the keywords for this card are broken heart, disappointment, and failed endeavor. And you can see, you know, she's looking at her stack of teacups. And she's just so sad. Maybe she was going to have a tea party and then the bitches just didn't come. There's any number of reasons why she might be feeling a bit cast down. And there's a number of reasons why people might be feeling cast down right now. And it's okay to feel your feelings, especially if you are at a new chapter, if you feel like if the world really is a different place than what you thought it was and you're having to reassess, is this actually so terrible or what the deal is? It's a very difficult, it's not an easy emotional space to be in. And of course, if you have a lot of people around you who are in that same space, you might all be feeding off of each other. So be careful what kind of energy you are absorbing from other people and be careful what they're absorbing from you because you might be making things a bit worse than what they really are. And the thing to remember is that failures, disappointments, even broken hearts, these are parts of life. They befall us all. They come to us all. We all have our terms when, it's just not going the way we envisioned or the way we hoped, or something did go the way we hoped and we thought it was what we wanted and it did not result in anything we actually wanted at all. That can happen as well. But it's important to remember these are just moments in time. The most productive thing we can do is to really reassess and then, you know, wipe your eyes, get up the next morning and just start trying to move forward from that point. Today's Celtic triad reads, three things never end, the flowering of charity, the soul, and perfect love. So in the matter of charity, the need for charity is seemingly without end. And in cases of genuine need, there are always people who rise to the occasion. In fact, one of the great scandals from the hurricanes that we had a couple months ago was the fact that the federal government was preventing people from offering aid. And by this time, you've probably heard in the news, it's a terrible scandal that FEMA was giving orders not to go to the houses of some people if they happened to have signs so in support of the now president-elect Trump. Imagine that. Hurricane disaster victims, and because of a political sign in their yard, FEMA, a federal institution whose sole reason for existence is to help people who've been affected by disasters, were happy to deny that help because of political issues. What a shameful thing. Now, I don't think this is who we are as Americans. I don't think this is who anyone really wants to be. Because when it comes to being in need and, you know, whatever, whether it's a natural disaster or whatever is going on, you have something like that. You know, people's politics don't matter. Their religion doesn't matter. Their ethnicity doesn't matter. Their sex doesn't matter. All of the things that we get preoccupied with on a daily basis, none of those things matter. The only thing that matters is that there are human beings who are in trouble. And when human beings are in trouble, we do have, especially in our society, you know, a natural desire of, I want to go help them, especially with something like natural disasters. I mean, you don't have any control, you know, those us mere mortals. You know, even amongst witches, you know, our ability to influence weather, it is limited. It's limited. If there's a disaster that is absolutely heading our way, there's only so much we're going to be able to do to protect ourselves. And of course, for normal people, you know, there's just no defense. You know, sometimes the hurricane hits you. Sometimes the earthquake shakes up your house. Sometimes you do get caught in that fire. Sometimes there is that tornado. Sometimes there's a flood. There's a million one things that are just going on in nature that are taking place with that we are helpless against. And that and when that happens, you know, it's not someone's fault. And I think there's a true spirit of neighborliness and fellow feeling, knowing that, you know, next time maybe that's me who's in that bad situation. This is a way of people paying it forward, and also people who once received great help during a disaster, sometimes they are moved to go out and help others the next time one comes around. So there is, as long as we're alive on Earth and life happens, there's always going to be a need for charity, and there's always going to be those people who, you know, for very pure motivations, just strictly benevolence towards their fellow man, will rise to that occasion. And then the soul. The soul is definitely without end, because it's the essence of who we are. It is energy, and energy can never be destroyed. It is only expressed. Sometimes it changes form. That certainly happens when we shed the mortal coil, and then we are existing as an energetic being until such time as we reincarnate. But the soul doesn't cease to exist at any time. It is always there. And then love. Love is an echo of the divine. And what's being referred to as perfect love is an expression of the divine, not merely mimicking it, not being the human rendition of it, but it is actually an expression of the divine itself. And you know, that's one of the things that's part of the ritual for Wiccans, for a beginning of rituals. You know, when people are entering into the circle of, you know, of coming in perfect love and perfect trust, what that is really meaning is it's referring to that divine level. We are coming together for this spiritual purpose. We are accessing the divine aspects of our nature, and so we are trying to reach that higher level of emotion and fellowship through that. And so that's just, it's an interesting thing to reflect upon. Now, for today's correspondence, it is the color gray, and I found as gray a picture as what I possibly could to represent it. It's a very November-esque picture, in my opinion. You know, the leaves are gone. You know, there's just a general mist. I mean, it's just it is about as gray as it gets on Earth. And gray does creep into November skies as this mist, or as a storm, or as just this blanket of overcast skies, and it's soft as a general rule. It's not abrasive, it's quiet, and it makes a person yearn for rest, which actually prepares the soul for the more drowsy winter that is about to arrive. And when we're in this state of this gray world, it's about slowing down, it's about taking a breath, and it's about living without the need of a witness or without the need to comment on everything else, to just be in the moment, to simply exist as we are. And we don't have very much of that these days. Thanks to social media, we all live very public lives, far probably more public lives than what's actually really good for us. Because it isn't about having a public life and, you know, a social life amongst people we see every day, and, you know, our neighbors, you know, people who are in our immediate community. It's, you know, we're having public lives in the way that only celebrities and politicians and royalty used to have public lives. Thanks to social media, you know, we all have that aspect of, you know, that's just out there. And I think it's time for us to really start thinking about what purpose that's serving. Is it actually helping us? Are we, you know, what's going on with that? And of course, you know, these gray, quieter days, that's the perfect time to reflect upon all those things. So today's practices, our quote comes from The Magical Household by Scott Cunningham and David Harrington, which if you do not have that book, may I encourage you to buy it. It's not very expensive. It is worth money. But they write, woods have their own magical powers and influences, and your chairs, couches, desks, and stools, in fact, all your wooden furniture, contain the energies of the woods from which they were made. And we have several keywords for the general kind of energy each of these woods has. For ebony, magical power and protection. For oak, strength, luck, health, protection. Pine, money, exorcism, healing. Redwood, longevity. Cherry, love. Teak, riches. Cedar, healing, longevity, purification, protection. Maple for love and money, mahogany protection specifically against lightning, rattan luck and strength, and walnut health. And you know, and these are just a few of the woods. I mean, of course, also these days, bamboo is a very common material that's used in a lot of things, including flooring. And by thinking about, you know, what kind of woods are actually in our home, that also might be worthwhile thinking about, you know, what how our homes were actually constructed, because they're retaining the energies of those materials used. And sometimes we overlook that, particularly in the amongst magical circles. It's just we have so many other things we're keeping track of. We're not also thinking about that. So from time to time, it's good to remind ourselves of what kind of energies we're actually inviting into our spaces, even at an ambient level. And maybe we might want to make a few adjustments here and there just to keep the magical atmosphere what we really prefer. And then for today's Thanksgiving fact, there is an official Thanksgiving postage stamp. In fact, when I looked that up on, I just did a Google search, apparently there are quite a few. So if you have a seasonal correspondence, you have a wealth of options. Put into practice a new habit, read a passage of Marcus Aurelius, and carry some bloodstone today. And in our journal, what professional lesson do you feel grateful for? And this doesn't have to be a hard lesson. Maybe it's a lesson you learned because of something that happened to somebody else, or it's a lesson that you learned from some success that you have. But whatever that lesson is, if you are thankful for it, write about that today. And on that note, everyone, have a magical day. Come back tomorrow for the next edition. Leave your thoughts for me in the comments below, and I will see you guys in the next one.